Waktu itu saya di sini sama teman-teman panitia, jadi panitia inaugurasi. Itu lagi masang lighting, karena kan masang lighting itu butuh apa? Bisanya cuma malam karena buat nyoba lampunya juga. Akhirnya kita tidur di sini kan, tidur di sini. Kita selesai semuanya, selesai itu sekitar jam 3 itu, terus setengah 4 kita mulai tidur di panggung terbuka, tidur di sini. Terus sekitar jam 4 itu terjun kami, aku sama teman-teman itu dengar suara yang enggak wajar pada waktu itu, pada saat jam 4-an itu. Itu suaranya dari sana, dari gedung B, kamar mandi gedung B. Itu terdengar orang lagi apa lagi nih? Lagi beras itu. Terus dengar suara kayak gitu, makin lama kok makin jelas. Anak-anak kesini pada lari semua, pada lari, ada yang ke musola, terus tidurnya pada pindah dari sini. Baru jam habis subuh itu, habis terdengar azan subuh, baru kesini lagi, terus pada tidur di sini, akhirnya nyampe pagi. Kenapa kan?
Good evening viewers. As we know, there are a lot of urban legends around us, which are told by our friends and also happen in ourselves. But actually, first of all, what is the urban legend itself? And based on David Emery a definition, urban legend is a fictional secondhand story, a thought as true and probable enough to be believed as about some ironic and embarrassing or horrific stories, and it actually happened to a real person. And what is the characteristic of urban legend itself? The characteristic or the attribute of the urban legend itself, again based on David Emery's definition. The first, it's a narrative or story. Second, it alleged to be true. The third, it is probable. Fourth, it's unproven. Five, it's spontaneous. Six, it's likely to take form from a cautionary tale. Seven, it's various in the telling. Eight, it's circulating by being passed from individual to individual, either it's orally or written. And the last, it is trustworthy secondhand sources.
Oh, ada suara kayak di dekat. Suara.